Okay, here I am in the middle of the night again making Halloween specials, and I'm gonna start this video by a Halloween mask, an actual like Michael Myers mask. Anyway, happy Halloween starts with happy laugh. Okay, so I'm gonna show you something because I am in the laboratory of Dr. Kitruidi. So I have these fake heads, like many of these head sculpts that are good for holding masks on intact. So you can basically put this on some shelf and then you have like a collection of scary stuff in there if you want to creep out people even more than the just the sheer look of this place that I have in here. But this is kind of like a mask that looks a lot like the Halloween 2008 Michael Myers movie by Rob Zombie. So this is a lot like that mask, even though it's not really officially trying to be like that, but it looks a lot like that. And the thing is that now it looks a lot more threatening and creepier when you have those black void eyes going on. And the way that it has those eyes is that I have a black hat inside here, winter hat. So if you put this hat inside them, then you can make them look like that, so that, and there's like this opening slit, but otherwise it's completely has this surrounding thing that it covers your whole head. Latex mask that has these hairs on them, and like the hair is part of the mask, and I think this looks really good. The lighting is not the correct way now, because there's like this artificial light that makes it a little bit different looking and more bright than it really is. It's more like this dark gray creepiness, but this is because I want to just show off different kind of masks, so it makes it look like it has this void eyes. So this is one of the masks, and then I'm going to let down the camera and show you another mask. Let's see one thing. I need to arrange these masks so that I don't show just anything here. Now this is another one. And here you got this mask, this kind of like a gimp, whatever it's called, mask. That there you can see the head in the mask. I have been using this also in the recording, just like that other Michael Myers mask. So this is kind of like a gimp mask, a little bit. And you can make it has this black thing on it. So let me see one thing. Oh, shit. Now, here's the hockey mask that looks like Jason Voorhees from Friday the 13th. So it's another Halloween-themed monster mask. So now if you put this mask on this one, then it kind of looks like some kind of... I have wore this. I can't put it correctly in my... just with holding it by one hand, so... excuse me, but I'm just demoing a little bit. There needs to be a real head and two hands, but I'm holding this camera with one hand. So the thing is that this is also a really cool mask. It's made out of plastic and metal and stuff, and well, while I was testing, this is one of... you can see me wearing this mask in one of the recordings that I have, at least one recording that I have in my videos on the site, in the talk show recordings. So in that video, I had the shading in the eyes so that the eyes look like this also. So they were almost like black completely. Like it covers the face so that you can't see nothing but the black shading in it. So that kind of shading makes it look a lot cooler. And then this kind of like gimp suit thing, there's a zipper here. It kind of covers the head so that you can't really see how the person inside looks like it. So you might wanna combine these masks to create this cool kind of combinations. I think this fits really well with this mask. So this is like the Jason hockey mask. So I'm also a violent hockey fan. So it all fits to the theme around this video. So this is one of those masks. It's like there's two in one. Just like there was one hat and that so cat in the hat. So let's see one thing. Okay, so there's a next one. So here you got like a ski mask. There's another one of those heads inside. Ski mask thing that has this hole. This is kind of like a winter clothing if you want to go into the midwinter of Finland. And then you got this like this filter, and there's the dust and stuff in there. But anyway, it doesn't go well when you don't put it the correct way. But anyway, it's kind of like a ninja mask or one of those, you know, Mortal Kombat masks. Looks like a mask of the Sub-Zero or Scorpion from Mortal Kombat. So if you put this kind of mask also, then you could make that kind of illusion of the dark shade being. If you have another mask on top of this, let me show you what I mean. Like, if you put a mask like this or some mask like this, this is basically like a, let me put it on and then I'm gonna show it the way it's supposed to be. So that I can use my both hands while I'm recording this. Let me try to put it the correct way. I'm still here, so this is not gonna be live recording or of any kind. So this is there's a shit ton of dust on it. Okay, so this is kind of like the spring fashion from last spring. Let me tell you, let's do one thing. My legs are really fucking hurting right now. I need to sit on this bench. Now this is the mask that I was mentioning, the spring fashion. It's a black doctor mask, basically. So this can also be used with a combination mask, that you have a ninja mask of some Mortal Kombat style or something. And then you can put some other mask on it and it covers your head completely and makes this black cool stuff, especially if you're in some dark location that it doesn't, this coloring is making it look like it's like bright gray, but it really it's really like pitch black. Sorry about the wrong coloring, but this is no professional video right now. And here you got some breathing holes in the black doctor mask, and you could actually put some. I'm just demoing a little bit. I'm not trying to make them be in the perfect pose or anything. It's just like those others. So you could there's a hole in them so that you could basically put them on some hold stand stick or something. Then these cool black doctor max. I really like this black doctor horror stuff also. So these have like this plastic things that you can see through, but you could also put something like, if you wanna start get creative, you could put some like these reflective glasses or like some other kind of things on these inside, or maybe stitch them together or glue them or put some tape in there somewhere. Then you could make them have these dark lenses on them. So basically that's this black doctor is one of them. This could be a mask for the Igor of this laboratory of mine, basically. Is like the henchman around here. So let me put it here and let me take another one. Let's see. Okay, let's take another horror core themed mask here. Let's continue. Fuck, this is slipping from my skeletal hands of Fortescue family. So this is another one of those heads, and there's another video game related what do you call this, scarf or something, but you could, it's kind of like a scarf and a ninja mask. Like this is actually from the game Dishonored 2. So as you can see, the coloring is exactly the same as the, at least the female in the Dishonored 2 stealth action game uses this kind of ninja mask on her face. So this is where that scarf is from. So it's a video game collectible. And also, let me put another scarf on it. I mean, a mask on it. Yeah, this mask that I'm trying to put doesn't really want to go there. Let me do one thing. This is really amateur kind of quality filming now. Damn. Okay, now it's okay, I think. So this is the mask that I was trying to show you. What is this thing on the way? Okay, so it's my finger. Okay, so I didn't even know exactly where the camera is recording. But this thing here is another horror mask. This now I'm trying to kind of demo you that you can put the mask inside and make the eyes look like these black void eyes. Well, this is basically a face covering remix mask of the character Sweet Tooth from the Twisted Metal Black and other Twisted Metal games. It has a little bit of that hair on it, and then you got like this toot toot and some really broken teeth and stuff. So this is like the psychopathic clown that you see, and he's really scary looking. And unfortunately, this that I'm looking at with my own eyes, the coloring in my own eyes is a lot better now, though. So he actually has this darker tone on him. Like, he looks like he's some kind of school, rotten school or something. Like, when you put the mask the correct way also, then I wish I would have that other mask now. But anyway, you put the Sweet Tooth mask on, and then you make the black eyes on it, and it looks really creepy. So this, you need to use it with another mask on, so that it has this effect on it, just like those other guys in there. So this goes together with another mask. So that's what I'm trying to do with one hand here, as you can see, maybe. So let me show you more masks now. Okay, so I'm gonna pick one. Okay, so there's a lot of masks here, and there's a lot of stuff in here too. So let's just take this mask off from the other one. Let me see which one should I use. I think I'm gonna use this one. I'm just gonna show you a little bit of demo of what you can do with the mask effects. That's why. So this is a black hat, black cat. So it has this in the eye region, you have nothing but darkness. So if I put a new mask on it, wait a second. There's the professional sound editing on the background. That's what you get from eating too much Halloween candy with lactose on him. Okay. Okay, so this one is the next Halloween monster mask. Now, this is, if you can recognize what this is, but this is basically also trying to be the, classic horror monster from the black and white movies? Like, this is the creature from the Black Lagoon. Like the, it's also a full head mask. Yeah, the coloring is also slightly better maybe in my own view. But anyway, if you have the black eyes, then it's gonna look a little bit creepier maybe. It's kind of like some kind of, I don't know what those things are called in some games. But anyway, I'm gonna show you another mask now, another monster kind of thing. Fuck, I think, okay, well, I don't know. Well, this is, I'm just gonna stream it straight away. I mean, like, completely just like record it straight away. So I'm not gonna make any cuts to this video. So this thing is the next mask. If you can recognize this, then you probably know the character, but this is basically the orc warlock from the Warcraft series. So he has like this beard, and you could kind of say that he's kind of like a mixture of Santa Claus and the Grinch in some way. You could basically cosplay that kind of creepiness if you want to. So he's also almost a complete full mask basically. So what can I say? I can't remember what the name was on the character, but it's from the Warcraft games and movie. So yeah, it's an orc. So let me put another mask on. I got plenty of more masks, so I could basically show you a huge collection of stuff. And this is kind of like also a horror mask, depending on how you want to see it. This mask has been with me in a lot of countries like Sweden and Japan and stuff. So you probably are gonna recognize this mask also if you know anything about these things. So this is the meme mask called Creepy Horse. That's the kind of like the same hair color as my own hair is and that Michael Myers down there. So this is the Creepy Horse mask. I think that's the way it's called. So I have this in my video avatar images right now, but this has been around the world and it looks a lot, it's a pretty good quality and it looks a lot like the genuine thing. So it basically is that kind of thing. The coloring is just slightly wrong and even the hair, even the eye color is kind of like my own eye color or somehow. It's weird how, so maybe it means that I'm supposed to play a character having this mask on and going crazy like Tom Green or something. So let's see about that and some videos. So let me show more. Oh shit, where did I put the mask? Where did I put that shit? Okay, so it's here, so I got so many things going on in here, so I can't remember where I put those things. Okay, so here's another interesting mask. I have been using this mask also in certain events. So here you go. Here you have a Donald Trump mask from around 5 years ago or something. It's a full head mask. The coloring is also pretty accurate, like it covers your whole face. And one thing that I did with this mask on, and others, I lent it others to mess around with, was my own little sister was getting married in 2017 or something, and I was playing this guest character, Donald Trump, and I even had this probably this same shirt on while I was doing that show. So I was messing around at the weddings, and I was kind of like trolling people that I'm like Donald Trump and stuff. So I was doing a guest appearance in there, playing this joke monster character. So yeah, that's about it. And I'm not gonna show very long stories about this mask, but this is one of the monster masks, lol, that I have in collection. I'm gonna show the next one. Next one is gonna be a Japanese meme mask. So this is a mask that one of my friends, Taka, has been weaving in talk show ideas and others. This is like a Japanese meme mask that is basically a bichon or a bichon bird. So you probably don't know where this is from, but it's kind of like these creepy animals that you got in some hilarious meme images from Japan and other countries. These are like the holes when you... Also, my mother wore this mask in some funny thing that we filmed. You can see out of those if you have... It's kind of like a small mask, so you need to have a pretty small head if you kind of fit into the scale, but otherwise pretty good. So let me show you another one. Okay, so this is a mask that was also in Japan. So this is kind of like a, you could say it's kind of like a Kung Fu Panda or something. It's not in the correct position now. The form is not correctly. Like it's supposedly be, like it's supposedly all round and stuff. But this is also worn. This was worn in Japan by Tolkki Storukkisu, and it's a full head panda mask, kind of like a creepy one. Also, and you can kind of like play some animality with these masks if you wanna put up some funny things. These messing around with the masks on and stuff. Probably we could use them to something like that if you film some creepiness with these on. Okay, I also cut some holes into this. This didn't have a hole in here, or it didn't have a hole in the ears either, but there's some more air going in there, so you kind of breathe better if you put a full. These are all like this latex masks, so they don't really breathe, and you might kind of suffocate inside from sweating too much or something like that, smelling the paint too much or something, so that might not be so healthy. So it kind of lets you breathe a little bit, so let me show more. Yeah, this is also kind of a smaller mask, smaller little mask. So this mask really is the mask. It's kind of like a the mask, the green mask from Jim Carrey was playing the this character in the 90s. It's I don't know if it's called anything but the mask, like the green mask that you put on and then you turn into this mask character from the cartoons, and was it in the comics or something? Yeah, so it's kind of cool, but it's kind of small mask also. And this mask arrived so that it had these eyes on it, so that you could kind of only see through some little holes in the sides or somewhere. So I cut out the eyes, and now it's kind of better so that you can use your own eyes to see out of there. So some of these masks kind of tend to have this kind of thing that you need to kind of operate some little bit of cuts in there, so they're gonna better somehow. Maybe if it's too small, then you might wanna make a breathing or opening in here so that you can kind of get it on more easily. But let me show you if I have some more showables. Did I have anything else there? Let's see. Okay, so basically those were the masks that I could show you right now. Maybe I do some another part where I could show you some more that's related to those and show you some more Halloween theme stuff that you could really use those around this season. So let me take this mask off. I mean off. Really good English again. So I'm not gonna make this to be a full length video, but this is already like double times already longer than the previous one. I'm just gonna tell you that gonna make more of these videos where I show you something and then they're kind of like maybe Halloween themed or something similar. But anyway, let's see you later about that stuff.